Hello everyone, let us talk something about ectoparasites on our pet's body. Ectoparasites are one of the most annoying things any pet parent or pet would have on its body. So ectoparasites basically are those parasites which are on the body of the pet, and these can be classified as macroscopic, that means which are visible to the naked eye, and microscopic, that are not visible to the naked eye. Of course, the microscopic ones, it has to be diagnosed using certain microscopic tests using a microscope, so that we better leave it as and when the condition appears. But the most annoying things, as I said, are these microscopic parasites, ectoparasites, which are mainly the ticks, fleas and the lice. Now, among these, we can easily identify what a tick is, what a flea is and what a lice is. Now, as a very simple difference among these three is the one which holds on to the body of the pet and doesn't move when you try to disturb it is a tick. So that is typically a round one. When you pluck out these ticks, you can find tiny ones or some enlarged ones. They become engorged after they suck blood, and you can see 6 to 8 legs on them, and these don't move when you actually disturb them. So these are basically ticks. Now when you come to lice are typically similar to the ones the humans have, and they are elongated, and whenever you try to actually catch them, they run and they try to hide in between the fur of the pet. Now fleas actually are very difficult to see, because the moment you try to touch them, the flea jumps away, and the jump is a pretty long jump for a flea, and we don't find fleas sitting on the body of the pet. So what is the damage done by all these, and what has to be done to prevent all these? What are the dangers, or what are the perils of perils that we can that can happen when your pet has these? So the first important thing I would like to talk about is the ticks, because among these three, the most important and the most dangerous ones are the ticks. Now, why are the ticks dangerous? They are dangerous because they not only bite and suck blood and cause irritation. They are dangerous because they can potentially transmit tick fever cases, and there are as many as 8 different parasites that a tick can harbor, and 8 different parasites it can transmit to your pet. So why does this happen and how does this happen? So for understanding that, we have to understand that when there is a tick on the body of the pet, we usually, most of the pet parents, they just pluck out and just throw them. And probably they just throw them out, but a tick can come back again and just get onto the pet's body, and then it can multiply, and when it multiplies, it can lay up to 3,000 to 5,000 eggs at a time, and it has a very short life cycle, and that's the reason when you have one or two ticks, suddenly within no time they become numerous on the pet's body. And the pet parents are really worried in those cases. So whenever you find a one tick or two ticks, few ticks, please do not take a chance. See your vet immediately and get rid of those ticks. Now, what damage do these ticks do? As I said, they suck a lot of blood. So if the dog is healthy enough and an adult, probably the impact might not be seen very early on. But if it's a small puppy and there are numerous ticks, the puppy becomes anemic and it may even succumb the anemia even before the tick fever can take over. Now, the second thing is, whenever a tick bites on the dog's body or the pet's body, so it causes a pretty good amount of irritation. So dog, your pet keeps on scratching, and even if you pluck out the tick, there is a scar there because the tick holds on very firmly to the dog's skin, and when you pluck out the ticks, it can cause irritation. Now, the most important aspect of fatality or I don't say fatality, but danger of having a tick on a pet's body is, as I told you, tick fever. Now, a tick fever, we have to understand here that tick fever is caused by so many parasites, and these parasites can be harbored by the ticks. And if the mother tick, if the female tick has the parasite in it, and she is laying eggs, suppose, as I said, if she is laying, say, around 5,000 eggs, so every egg or every newborn tick will have that parasite. So that means from one single tick, the number of ticks carrying the parasite is enormously increasing by leaps and bounds. So in, it becomes in thousands. So whenever there is a tick, we cannot find out that the tick has the parasite or not. It's pretty impossible. So what should we do is important. We should always ensure that if you find a tick on your dog's body, or if there is a previous history of your dog having ticks, get your dog's temperature check first, because the first classic sign of a typical tick fever is high fever. Now, if the dog is having high fever, most of the times it will be very normal early on until the disease develops inside and the dog becomes really sick. The disease progresses very fast. So whenever there are ticks on your body, on the body of your pet, it's mandatory that you get your dog's temperature checked, or you can check it at your home itself. And if the temperature is crossing 104 or above, so then classically it has a tick fever, and that has to be diagnosed by your vet. So please do not neglect that. Now, the second thing in tick fever cases is, most of the tick fevers which are caused by different parasites and which are transmitted by ticks, these typically cause a lot of destruction of the RBCs inside the dog's body or the pet's body. So there is anemia, the dog will not be eating properly, it might pass yellow urine, and progressively that urine color might change to red color, and or it's a typically hemoglobinuria, what we say, it's coffee colored urine. So then the dog may be severely anemic, it may be severely lethargic, and it may need very, very aggressive treatment. So whenever there are ticks, before these symptoms are starting, please get your dog treated or checked by your vet. Now, even if all the ticks are removed, typically I have seen many people saying that ticks are all gone, so my dog is safe. No, the parasite can be still in the dog's blood, and it can potentially again cause a disease. So what is important is, even if the ticks are removed and the dog appears to be healthy and the temperature is normal, then also I suggest that the temperature must be checked every day, at least 2 times or 3 times a day for the next 10 days. At least for the next 10 days. If the temperature is normal and it is constant, then probably your dog is free from a tick fever. And if the temperature is rising or fluctuating, then you cannot be complacent. The dog has to be definitely taken for a checkup with your vet. Now, these are the dangers of the dog when it has ticks on its body, and I request everyone not to be complacent when you find ticks on the body. Now, the most important way to find a tick or lice on the body is simple grooming. The reason being, unless and until the ticks are numerous in number, you will not be able to find on the body, because most of the dogs are hairy. Now, a tick typically hides itself in such a place on the dog's body which is not usually visible, or which we usually skip out while touching our pet, so or while cuddling our pet. So usually it's below the chin or this part, or sometimes on the neck, most importantly under the base of the tail, between the paws. So these are the places where the ticks usually hide when they are in few in number. So the important thing which you should be doing at home is, regular grooming will help you find if there are any ticks on your body. So we must always check the paws, in between the paws, behind the ears, under the neck. So these are the places where the ticks usually hide and do the damage. So the grooming is very, very important to know whether our dog has ticks. So regular grooming is advised, and especially for a hairy breed, regular grooming is advised at least twice a day. How do we control ticks? So there are a lot of medications available in the market commercially, but most of these medications include spot-ons, they have shampoos, there are so many things. But we must understand that chemical applications for control of ticks is always temporary. The ticks might again come because of the short life cycle and because of the number of the progeny they are actually giving birth to. Within short time or within no time, almost there are multiple and numerous ticks around the premises, especially if the premises is open and has a garden kind of area. So those pet parents have a really tough time in controlling the ticks. The second thing is, no matter how many times we apply these anti-tick shampoos or anti-tick medicines on the pet's body, they might again reappear, because until then they hide in those small cracks or those small gaps between the walls, and there they lay eggs, and they are pretty resistant and they can stay for quite a some time. Especially in summers, they really multiply really very fast, and we find a lot of ticks during this time. Now, what do we do when a pet has ticks? So just simply plucking out them and throwing them somewhere doesn't help. So if you happen to pluck the ticks out, I suggest that one or two ticks, of course you can pluck them out. So I suggest that you burn them completely by placing them on a piece of cotton. So that means you are burning even the eggs inside. So that can be again, there is no chance of the eggs hatching and giving rise to new ticks. So whatever the reason, if the ticks are plenty in number on the body, there are certain medications which you have to follow your vet's advice. I request personally, don't treat your dog at home for ticks. The dog has to be examined thoroughly for other conditions like the temperature, the respiration, the level of anemia that has been caused. So these are the things which are very, very important. Now the next important ectoparasite or parasite on the dog's body are the lice. These lice, they, as just as human lice, they don't stick at one place. They can, just travel along the body. The most important thing the lice cause irritation. The lice cause a lot of irritation, and there are certain lice which can actually suck blood. So there are two types of lice basically in our pet's body: the biting and the chewing lice. So the chewing lice, they cause a lot of chewing on the skin, so the pet has a lot of irritation. The biting lice, they sucking lice, they basically suck the blood, so they potentially can cause anemia. And these lice, they cause a lot of irritation on the body, so the dog keeps on scratching very heavily. And so there are medicines for the lice also, so they can be controlled very easily. A simple lice shampoo, anti-lice shampoo or anti-lice application will help in removing those lice. So nevertheless, you must visit your vet whenever you find lice on the body of your pet. Now the third important ectoparasite here is the flea. This flea is typically, it's a very tiny fly kind of thing which doesn't stay on the body, just comes, bites the pet and just jumps away. So whenever this flea bites, now there is a lot of allergy caused due to the saliva of the flea, which is very, very, very allergic to the pet. And this is the reason why the pet bites itself to an extent that it mutilates itself in that area where the fleas bite, and it is mostly on the back part. So whenever you find these kinds of things, I request you not to do home remedies kind of things. Please get a checkup with your regular vet, and your vet will suggest what has to be done and what has to be what medication has to be given. So nevertheless, these ectoparasites can be found out properly and thoroughly only when you are grooming your dog. So your pet must be groomed every day is what I suggest. When these are found on your pet's body, please do not neglect. They can really cause a lot of medical issues for your pet, and please see your doctor for the next and the best remedy. Thank you so much. I hope this was useful for you. Thank you so much. Stay safe, stay happy. Thank you.